Happy Friday, Centennial Cougars. I'm Gabby Anthony.
And I'm Logan Linthal. Thanks for joining us. It's Football Friday again.
And tonight, we take on Ravenwood.
Last week, we had a big win against our rival Franklin, and we head into this week taking on Ravenwood.
Got a quick word with some of the players.
All right, I'm here with
Dominic Reed.
Trip Newman.
All right, and how are y'all feeling about the game last week?
Last week, man, it feels good to, you know, beat the flagship, you know. I mean, we went in there, took their money, did what we had to do.
I mean, it felt great. I think we could have played a little better, but it was great to get the win in the flagship.
All right, and we got Ravenwood this week. How are we feeling about that?
Oh, you know, we're preparing hard in practice, you know, studying film, you know, just going to come ready to play Friday.
Trip?
I think we feel confident. We're going to have a good week of practice and get ready to kick Ravenwood's, you know.
All right, so I'm here with
Digno.
And how are you feeling about the football season so far?
I feel completely and utterly amazing.
Why is that?
Because I'm a GOAT. And we're all GOATs. And our defensive line always gets it done.
How you feeling about the game on Friday?
I think it's going to be a dogfight every single down, and we're going to win.
How do you feel about this past week's win against Franklin?
I feel pretty good about it. You know, we won that trophy back, so that's always good.
How you feel about the season going forward?
I'm pretty confident in the season and our ability to surpass all these other trash teams.
All right, thank you.
Here's some highlights from last week's game.
Hockey season is finally underway.
Here's a quick word with some of the players.
All right, so I'm here with
Jack Finn.
Adam Horner.
And I know the hockey season's underway. How do you feel about the season going this far?
It's going all right so far. A little bit of a slow start, but it should pick up soon, so it's all right.
How about you?
Yeah, I mean, I feel like our season's going pretty all right, considering we just started it. And I think we'll be improving along as the season goes along. So,
how are you feeling about the upcoming games?
We have Ravenwood tonight, so that's a pretty big game. Excited about that one. Then Mount Juliet on the 17th, and I think that's a dub too, so pretty good.
You feeling pretty good about those?
I do feel pretty good about the games. We play Ravenwood tonight, and it should be a good game. And then Mount Juliet here in a couple weeks, so it should be fun.
Are you going to the hockey game?
Yeah, go support the hockey team.
Everyone, please go to the hockey games. We need a big crowd there. Go hockey. All right, so I'm here with
Brady Diamond.
And then the hockey season underway. How did the last two games go?
They went all right. We tied to Franklin, but we lost to Brentwood by one.
And how are you feeling about the rest of the season?
I think I'm feeling pretty good. We know what we got to do to get the job done.
Do you know any about your upcoming games, who you play?
We play Ravenwood, or we played Ravenwood Wednesday, but they're really good. so it's not really.
All right, thank you.
The girls' soccer season postseason is underway.
They played in the district finals last night, and we got a quick word with some of the players about that game.
All right, so I'm here with
Caitlin,
Jenna,
Lily.
And on Tuesday, we had a big game against Franklin in the district tournament. Tell me how that went.
It went really well. We ended up winning in PKs, so I'm really happy about it.
All right, and on Thursday, you guys play Ravenwood. Tell me about thoughts going into that.
Well, we're really excited to make it to the final. It's going to be a tough game, but I think if we work hard like we did against Franklin, we can win.
All right, and after fall break is the regional tournament. Tell me about your thoughts going into that.
We're really excited because we've never made it this far before, so we hope to just keep going on, and we're really excited.
All right, good luck. All right, so I'm here with
Coach Williams.
And on Tuesday, we had a big game against Franklin. Tell me how that went.
It went well. It was a very exciting game. We ended up going into extra time and into PKs, where we came ahead 5-3.
All right, and what are your thoughts going into Thursday, the district game?
Yeah, so Thursday is the district final against Ravenwood. We held them tight in the regular season the first half, and then kind of did some changes strategically in the second half, and we found it to not be advantageous. So we're just going to focus on kind of how we can keep that game close and how we can be better than we were the first time.
All right, and after fall break is a regional game. Tell me your thoughts going into that.
Yeah, so region will be after fall break, which I think it's important that the girls get some well-needed rest, and then making sure that we are prepared for whomever it is that we will have to face when we come back.
All right, thank you. Are you interested in playing lacrosse?
Here's some information about the team with some of the players.
I'm here with
Joaquin Brown.
So I hear that you play for the lacrosse team for Centennial. How are y'all looking this year?
We're looking all right. We got our few upperclassmen that are good and experienced, and we got a lot of up-and-coming freshmen, but we need more players, so sign up if you would like to play. I mean, right now it's just fall ball, so you can really just hop in, do whatever, and then when spring comes around, we can get into the season, get into some ball.
Okay, and what advice do you have for the underclassmen coming up?
I mean, it's a hard sport coming from middle school to high school, playing Ravenwood, Brentwood, all those big teams. But stick with it, get in the gym, build some muscle, and you'll be good. Yeah.
Thank you, Joaquin. I'm here with
Atticus Bro.
How's the lacrosse season going this year?
It's going good. Practices are good. We haven't had a game yet, but practices are good.
And the freshmen that's wanting to join, what days do you all practice?
So we practice on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays.
Okay, and where do you all practice at?
We practice above the soccer field, or the practice soccer field.
Okay, thanks, you Atticus Broad.
Oh, and please join, like it's a lot of fun. Come play.
Thank you.
One group that will definitely be at tonight's game is the CHS band.
And it's official. It's one of the best bands around.
I'm here with
Mr. Baxter.
Mr. Baxter, the band been real lit this year. You come here, you change a lot, huh? You got lit outside. What'd you do?
Well, I do what I do, man. Just, you know, we put some dance moves on them, went to my little song book, and just make sure they have fun. The most important thing is for the students to have fun. So we want to make sure that's going to be the number one thing. Yeah.
For the past years, I haven't saw the dance, you know. I mean, you feel me? Like, jigging.
I don't know what you're talking about. You talking about me? I don't dance like that.
Y'all all be dancing.
Oh, never mind.
So when do you all practice?
Monday, Tuesday, Thursday mainly. On Mondays, we just do sectionals where the drums will meet by themselves, the wind players will meet by themselves, and the color guard meet. They separate on Mondays. Tuesdays and Thursdays, we put everything together. Yeah.
Okay, and do y'all travel to, like, away games also? Because I know y'all are at all home games.
Yeah, we travel. We did not go to the Dixon game because we had a contest that following day, and it was just going to be a little bit late. But we try to make all the games. Yeah.
So I hear about the competition that you all had last week. How'd y'all do?
We traveled to Lebanon. They were the small division champions. So out of all of the bands in two classes, there actually beat some bands that were bigger than they were and whatnot. So they were grand champions there. The percussion has had a real good season. The drums, they have for 2 weeks in a row, they've gotten the highest overall score.
I mean, that's real good for us. I mean, I've never heard about them going that far. since the past years. Yeah. So how do you feel about that?
I feel good. I feel like they're off to a really good start. They actually had a competition the week before that in Trousdale County, and they were the sweepstakes winner there as well. So this is 2 weeks in a row now that they've, you know, scored really, really well at contests.
Thank you, Mr. Sebastian.
All right, as you guys know, homecoming is approaching, and my boy Griffin right here, he still needs a date, so we're going to go find him a date. We're on our way to Miss Gary's class. We're going to go make, like, a clever little sign and see what girls we can be pulling, you know? See if we can get Griffin a date. Hoco. All right, works good enough. I'm here with...
Ella Murray.
Piper Gilbert.
Okay, and do you ladies have a homecoming date for... You don't? Well, you're in luck.
Oh my God, babe.
Dude, do you accept?
I do. I do.
All right, so the plan is to get Miss Tally to like, just for Griffin to ask Miss Tally. So we're going to her class right now. Miss Tally, as you know, homecoming's coming up. And we're just wondering if you had a date or anything like that. Or
I do not need a homecoming date.
But you don't have a date is what you're saying. Right here. My friend Griffin.
No. Oh, I'm sorry, Griffin. No, Griffin. But I still love you.
Wow. All right, so I'm here with...
Caroline.
Gabby.
Caitlin.
And do you lovely ladies happen to have Hoco dates?
No.
No. Griffin, come on out.
you guys
accept?
Yes!
Go.
The kink in the rail got me kinky.
Okay, Logan. Will you take Griffin to Hoco?
What?
Yes, no?
Yes?
Yes,
do
no.
It.
Asking both of you guys.
Yes.
Will you take Griffin to Hoco?
Yes.
Well, will you take Griffin to Hoco?
No.
It says Hoco.
Oh, wow. Will you take Griffin Chandler to homecoming?
Yes. No.
Oh. Will you take Griffin Chandler to homecoming?
God, no.
Oh, nah.
Lena, back off for a second.
Oh, shoot.
Taylor, Lauren.
Oh, shoot.
Hi, Lauren. Okay.
Will you take Brayden to homecoming?
For content, it's not serious.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Oh, yes.
Gang.
I'm here with
Ella Murray.
And what are you most excited for about Powder Puff?
I'm really excited to see the guys like cheer routine stuff, and I'm also really excited to see the girls just like play football.
Hey, I'm here with
Rico.
J1K.
What are you most excited about for Powder Puff?
I don't really know, but whatever they do.
I think Yalaysia Carter playing. If she playing, I can't wait to see her tackle all these females. Yes.
Oh, man. Hey, Powder Puff, they finna go hard.
On me, they finna go hard, especially Yalaysia. That's a dude on bro. I love you, though.
On me.
I'm here with
Leandra.
And Nino.
What are your opinions on Powder Puff? Like, are you excited for it, or...
Yeah, personally, I think they're going to do really good. A lot better than our freshman team did.
Yeah.
And I think the boys will slay as cheerleaders.
I've seen the practices. I would say I don't really know how they're going to do, only because the coaches weren't there. So, and a lot of the coaches that were there are the football players. And some of them, as I heard from the players, they didn't know what to do, and they weren't that big of a help. So I feel like there's going to be a lot of fights out there, a lot of drama out there.
But don't you think they'll do better than you guys did?
Well, I wasn't there half the time. I got a concussion, so.
You weren't? Because last time I checked, you were in half the game.
Okay, I'm here with
AJ.
And what are your opinions on Powder Puff? Are you excited for it? Like, what? What?
What is that?
It's when the girls play football and the boys do cheerleading.
Oh my God, that sounds amazing.
All right, I'm here with
Lainey.
Okay, and what are your opinions on Powder Puff?
It's epic.
Are you excited for it?
Definitely.
I'm here with
BJ.
What are your opinions on Powder Puff? Are you excited for it?
Yeah, I guess so. I've, like, never really seen it before, but I'm excited, you know?
Sly, I'm here with?
Tanner.
Are you excited for Powder Puff?
Yes.
What are your overall opinions on it?
The juniors are gonna win.
With?
Audie Spain.
Addison Polly.
Grace Ashby.
What are your opinions on Powder Puff?
I love it. It seems so much fun.
I can't wait till I can do it too.
I'm so excited.
Are you two both excited for it?
Yes.
So excited.
One amazing group of CHS students isn't just doing great things here.
They're also making a big impact on the community.
Hi, I'm Remy, and I'm here to talk about One Generation Away with Gabriel.
We fill up bags for food for people who are in need.
When you go to work, how do you feel?
It makes me feel happy and proud.
Thank you.
One of our job sites that our student going is One Generation Away, and is for a great cause, and they are so proud of the job that they are doing in there. And I'm gonna pass it to Mr. Arnold to explain more.
Yeah, One Generation Away is a nonprofit organization, and they take in donations from stores, farms, all kinds of places, and they take in mountains of food. They got a huge warehouse up on Southeast Parkway. And what they do is they repackage and distribute this stuff locally as well as many places around the country, especially where disaster relief is needed. And what our guys are working on right now is a thing called doorstep. And what they're doing is they put up bags of food, and there's like some vegetable in there, some fruit, there's pasta sauce, cereal, some basic type things. And they're gonna distribute those to people that sign up on an internet site that need the food. Typically it's people that can't get out, they don't have transportation, they can't get to the store, and a lot of them don't have a whole lot of money. So they've joined up with DoorDash is actually gonna do the delivery of these food bags within a 10-mile radius of Franklin right now. But our guys run like an assembly line, putting all these foods in a bag and putting it on a pallet, and they really enjoy it, and they do a fantastic job.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
Fall break starts after today.
What are your plans for your big week off?
Hello, time for interviews. My name's Jeremy, and I'm here with
Logan.
And what are you doing over fall break? You got any fun plans?
I'm going to Kansas for a college visit for 2 days.
That's so cool. What are you doing at the college visit?
Well, I'm going to visit their engineering program, and I'm also going to check out their soccer team.
Fun. You heard it here first.
You're getting interviewed.
All right, what are you doing over fall break?
I will be relaxing at home and making lots of gracious meals.
Very cool. You heard it here first. Hello, sir. My name is Richard, and this is
Max.
And Max, what are you doing over fall break?
Nothing. Literally nothing.
Sounds fun.
Anyone want to do anything? Please.
Hit this man up. He's lonely. All right, I'm here with
Tessa, Colette.
And what are you guys doing over fall break?
I'm going to the beach.
Absolutely nothing.
Sounds fun.
Physics students are ready to jet out of here, literally.
Here's a look at how they're zooming through the hallways.
She is currently hovering off the ground. And this is interesting, very interesting. And we gone. We gone. Oh my God.
She just kept going.
Are you okay? You okay?
Yeah, I'm good.
How was it?
It was quite a thrill.
Nice. All right, so as y'all can see, she just did that amazing project, if you want to call it. How was the experience?
It was quite a thrill, honestly. It was kind of scary because I turned when I came back this way, so I couldn't see what was in my way.
Yeah, we were very concerned. As you guys can see, they're actually about to do it again. Come on, let's take a walk with them. All right, so as we have these lovely helpers down here, we're gonna ask them, everybody over here, you know what I'm saying? Oh, he's coming back. Out the way. They can't lift? Y'all can't lift him?
I can't get him up.
They cannot get him up. All right, guys, here he goes. And he's gone. Oh! All right, man. So, how was that experience right there?
Yeah, it was pretty fun. Yeah.
Nice, nice. Are you hurt in any sort of kind of way?
Cause no.
It's a pretty big impact.
Nah, I'm all right.
Grandpa fought in World War II. He was such a noble dude. I can't even finish school. Missed my mom and left too soon.
And your first question is, how many times did KSI connect punches with Logan Paul in the sixth round of their first fight in 2018?
2018, sixth round, connect punches. 75.
10?
19 times.
Three punches.
Two.
That is incorrect. It is 13. All right, your next question. Who solved the Millennium Puzzle?
The Millennium Puzzle. Pikachu.
That is incorrect. It is Yugi.
Yugi! Yu-Gi-Oh.
Yugi.
Close enough. It is Yugi, but we'll take it. Take it. Your next question. What is Coach Glover's first name?
Jim.
That is incorrect. It is James. That's correct. Your next question. Name the original six Avengers.
Hawkeye, Black Widow, Thor, Captain America, Iron Man, and the Hulk.
That is correct.
From the movies or the comics? Iron Man, Captain America, Hawkeye, Black Widow, Thor, the Hulk.
That is correct.
Original six Avengers. Michelangelo, Raphael, and Leonardo. I don't know. Goofy, Dopey, and Sleepy.
That is incorrect. It is Captain America, Iron Man, Black Widow, Hulk, Thor, and Hawkeye. Your next question and last question. What is the highest scoring Super Bowl game and who played in it?
The highest scoring Super Bowl game. Ooh, I don't know. I'm going to go, it was 64-63, and the New England Patriots won because they're the best.
No.
That is incorrect. It is San Francisco and Chargers with the score being 49-26. You're close, though. Hey, good job.
Hey, let me play. It was my 49ers, and I think the other team was the Chargers, and the score was 49-26.
Good job. Second time to do it, 5 out of 5.
You know, they say big time players and big time plays, but I'm so big time, I'm in my own world. Woo!
Man, Patriots and Seahawks.
That is incorrect. It is San Francisco and Chargers.
Okay.
You were close,
okay.
So.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
Good job.
Enjoyed it.
Yeah.
Enjoyed it. Deuces.
Deuces.
That's all our time for now.
Have a good break.
And go Cougs.
Go Cougs.